This is Ganesh Reddy and I welcome you to the Knowledge Treasure Hub. So today we are going to see operations on binary numbers. So binary operations. So mainly there are two operations that we perform on binary numbers. So that is binary addition and binary subtraction. Even in computer also, it performs only two operations, means only one operations, only addition. So by using addition only, so all the remaining operations are going to be performed. So subtraction, multiplication, division. So the main key rule is performed by the addition operation. So we'll see what is binary addition. So it looks like a normal addition operation with what we perform in our day-to-day life. So we'll see what is binary addition. So let me to take two 1-bit numbers, so A as well as B. So both are 1-bit numbers. So how many possible configurations are possible? So 0, 0. So what will be the sum as well as carry? So when we add two zeros, the sum will be obviously 0. And here there is no carry, so carry is also 0. So for 0, 1. So for 0, 1, when we add to 0, 1, so the sum will be 1, carry, no carry, so 0. So when we take A as 1, so B as 0, so 1, 0, so of course the sum will be 1. Here also there is no carry. So when we take 1, 1, the sum will be 1. What? So when we take 1, 1, the result will be 2. But here the sum came as 0. Yes. So in case of binary representation, so 1 plus 1 will be 2. There is no change in it. So 1 plus 1 will be 2. So what is the binary representation of 2? It will be 1, 0. So 1, 0 will be the binary representation of 2. So since the sum also consists only 1 bit, it can also store only 1 bit. So we are storing, so this LSB, least significant bit in sum. So this 1 bit will be stored in carry. So for 1, 1, the sum will be 0 and carry will be 1. So 1 plus 1 will be, of course, obviously 2. So the binary representation of 2 will be 1, 0. So the least significant bit LSB is stored in sum column, so sum register. So this MSB will be stored in carry. So this is the binary addition. So this is simple 1 bit binary addition. So let me give an example of binary addition. So 5 plus 5. So the result will be 10, right? So take binary representation of 5. So it will be 0, 1, 0, 1. So similarly, binary representation of 5, 0, 1, 0, 1. So we add. So 1 plus 1 will be 0, carry will be 1. So 0 plus 0, 0, 0 plus 1, 1, so 1. So 1 plus 1, 0, carry will be 1, so 1. So 1, 0, 1, 0. So we know this is 10. So it's 8, 4, 2, 1. So 8 plus 2 will be 10. Right? So this is simple binary addition. So next we'll see binary subtraction. So here also the same procedure will be followed. So let me take A, B, two 1-bit numbers. So what will be the subtraction? So here instead of carry, so what will be? So here borrow. So when we are performing subtraction operations, so we get borrow. So let me take 0, 0. So 0 minus 0, it will be 0 only. So there is no borrow. So borrow will also be 0. Next one is 0, 1. So remember, I will come to this a little bit later. Next one is 1 0. So 1 minus 0, subtraction will be 1. So no borrow. So 1 1 1 minus 1 0. Here also no borrow. So 0 minus 1. So 0 minus 1 will be -1 in our regular subtraction. So but here the subtraction will be 1 and the borrow also will be 1. So here 0 means, so we will take 1 borrow, so it will be 2. So this is a 2 representation. 1 0 will be 2's representation, right? So 1 borrow will be taken, so the result will be 2. So 2 minus 1 will be 1. So here the subtraction will be 1, as well as we taken 1 borrow, so borrow will also be 1. So this is the binary subtraction. It seems to be somewhat difficult, right? So to overcome this difficulty, we come to one topic called complements. So complements reduces this difficulty in binary subtraction. So complements uses again the binary addition. So by using addition, so we can perform subtraction with the help of complements. So now we'll see complements. So complements reduces the subtraction process difficulty, and it also used in several binary manipulations in the digital computer. So for each and every number system, we have two types of complements. So R's complement, R minus 1's complement. Here R is represents radix. So base is also called as radix. In the first class itself, we have discussed that for each and every number system, we have a base. That base represents the number of numbers in a number system. For binary number system, we have base as 2. So the base is also called as radix. So again for octal, so we have radix as 8. For hexa, we have radix 15. For decimal, we have radix 10. So for each and every number system, we have radix. So that radix represents number of numbers in a number system. So for each and every number system, we have two types of complements. So this is R. So R's complement, R minus 1's complement. For binary number, we have R's complement, means the 2's complement. R minus 1's complement means 1's complement. Similarly, for octal, we have 8's complement, 7's complement. For decimal, 10's complement, 9's complement. For hexadecimal, 15's complement, 14's complement. So that is, we have two types of complements. So we'll go to first 1's complement in binary number system. So 1's complement. So this is very simple to get 1's complement of a binary number system. So let me give an example. So 1 0 1 0 1 0. So this is a binary representation. So what will be the 1's complement of this number? So this is binary representation, right? So 1's complement of this binary representation is very simple. So we need to change 0 to 1 or 1 to 0. So 0 will be changed to 1, 1 will be changed to 0. 0 will be changed to 1, 1 will be changed to 0. Okay, 0 to 1, 1 to 0. So this is the 1's complement representation. So to convert it is very simple. So but what is the logic behind this one? We'll see. So to convert any r minus half complement, we need to subtract the number with the highest possible number in that number system. For suppose the same, so 1 0 1 0 1 0. So this is a binary representation. To do r minus 1's complement means, so for binary r is equal to 2. So r minus 1 means 1's complement. To do 1's complement, what we need to do means we need to subtract this number from the highest possible number in the same number system. The highest possible number, so here we have only two options, 1 and 0. So when we take all our 1's, so 1, 1, 1, 1, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 4, 5, 6. So this is the highest possible number in binary number system for 6 digits. So here the question asked him 6 digits. So here also we taken 6 digits. So we need to subtract this number from the highest possible number. So 1 0 1 0 1 0. So we need to subtract. So 1 minus 0 1 1 minus 1 0 1 minus 0 1 1 minus 1 0 1 minus 0 1. So 1 minus 1 0. So 0 1 0 1 0. So here also the same result, 0 1 0 1 0 1. So this is the regular procedure. So but in a shortcut we are doing, so just alteration, so just complement, just we are placing an inverter. So 0 to 1 1 to 0 0 to 1 1 to 0 0 to 1 1 to 0. So this is a shortcut. So this is about 1's complement. So the next one is 2's complement. So 2's complement, 2's complement is nothing but 1's complement plus 1. So r's complement of any number system is that by adding 1 to the LSB after r minus 1's complement. Means r's complement is equal to r minus 1's complement plus 1. So here also 2's complement is equal to 1's complement plus 1 is added to the LSB. So to perform 2's complement, let me give an example. So we need to perform a 1's complement for 1 1 1 0. So let me take 0 here. So 1 0 1 0 1. So this is a binary representation. We need to perform a 2's complement. So to perform 2's complement, of course, in the first step, so we need to perform 1's complement. So 1's complement of this number will be, so 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, right? So to do 2's complement, so we need to add 1 to the 1's complement. So add 1 to the LSB. So this is LSB, this is OMSB. So we need to add 1 to the LSB, so 0 plus 1 1 1 0 1 0. So this is 2's complement of a given number. So to perform r's complement, so we need to perform r minus 1 complement and add 1 to the LSB in r minus 1 complement. So this is 1's complement, 2's complement. Similarly, for any number system, we have two types of complements, r's complement, r's minus 1's complement. For let me take a decimal number system. So decimal number system also have 10's complement as well as 9's complement. So to do r minus 1's complement, we need to subtract the number from the highest possible number in the given number system. So to perform r minus 1's complement for 3, 5, 9. So the, what is the highest possible number in a 3 digit in decimal number system? 999. So 999 is the highest possible number in decimal number system in 3 bits. So we need to subtract. So 9 minus 1, 9, 0. So 9 minus 5, 4. 9 minus 3 will be 6. So 6, 4, 0 is the 9th complement of 3, 5, 9. So to perform 10th complement of the same number 359, so we need to add 1 to the LSB. So 6, 4, 1 will be the 2th complement of 359. So similarly for octal, hexadecimal, the same procedure we need to follow. So this is about complements. So why we are using complements? To reduce the difficulty in binary subtraction. So we'll see the binary subtraction by using 1's complement as well as by using 2's complement. So binary subtraction using 1's complement. So A, B are two numbers, two binary numbers. So they may be any bit numbers. So let me to take an example. So A as 4 bit number as well as B as 4 bit number. So 1, 1, 1, 1. So this is 15. A is 15. So 1, 1, 1. So B as 5. So 0, 1, 0, 1. So this is 5. So now we need to subtract it so that the result will be 10, right? So 15, so B as 5. So we need to subtract A from B, B from A, sorry. So the result will be 10. So to perform binary subtraction using 1's complement, so we need to take 1's complement of the any one number. So B, we'll take 1's complement of B. Then we need to perform the simple binary addition. So A plus 1's complement of B. So the result will be A plus 1's complement of B. So A minus B is equal to A plus 1's complement of B. So the result will be A plus 1's complement of the B. So here there will be two conditions. If the result consists of carry, then the result will be positive. So we need here, we need to add carry to the LSB. So if there is no carry, means the result in negative form, and we need to convert again. It is in 1's complement. So we need to perform 1's complement. So let me give an example, then it will be clear. So here we need to perform 1's complement of B. So 1's complement of B will be, so B is 0, 1, 0, 1. So 1's complement of B will be 1, 0, 1, 0. Now we need to add A plus 1's complement of B. So here A is, so 0 plus 1, 1, 1 plus 1, 0. So carry, 1 plus 1, 0, carry. So 1 plus 1, 0, 0 plus 1, 1, so there is carry. So since there is carry, so the result is positive. So to get the result, so final result, so the LSB need to be added to the, so the carry need to be added to LSB. So we are adding this carry here. So 1 plus 1, 0. So 1, 0, 1, 0, which is 10. So the result is, since that is carry, the result is positive. So 15 minus 5 plus 10. So here also we got plus 10. So this is binary subtraction using 1's complement. So we need to take 1's complement of B. So we need to add that to A. So here we got carry. So the result is positive, and we need to add that carry to the LSB. So we got the final answer. So 1, 0, 1, 0. So this is one example. Let me give another. There is another case also. Let me give another example also here. So let me give 5 minus 15. So A is 5. 0, 1, 0, 1. So A is 5. So B is 15. So 5 minus 15 minus 10 will be the answer. So similarly, we need to take 1's complement of B. So B is 1, 1, 1, 1. So 1's complement of B will be 0, 0, 0, 0. So we need to add A to the 1's complement of B. So A is 0, 1, 0, 1. So 1 plus 0, 1, 0 plus 0, 0, 0 plus 1, 1, 0 plus 0, 0. So 0, 1, 0, 1. So no carry. So the result is in a negative form. So and since there is no carry, so the result is in 1's complement form. To get the final result, again we need to perform 1's complement on 8. So perform 1's complement on 8. So 1's complement perform will get 1, 0, 1, 0. So which is 10. So minus 10 is the result. Since there is no carry, we confirm that the result is in negative form and it is in 1's complement form. Again, we need to perform 1's complement to get the final result. So this is about 1's complement subtraction, binary subtraction using 1's complement. We'll see next binary subtraction using 2's complement as well. So now let's see binary subtraction using 2's complement. So we know how to get 2's complement of a number. So we need to get 1's complement of a number. Then we need to add 1 to the LSB of a 1's complement number. So here also in binary subtraction using 2's complement, same procedure. Let me give A, B. So here I will take the same examples, then it will be clear to you. So A has 15. B as 5. So the result needs to be 10. So to perform binary subtraction using 2's complement, we need to take 2's complement of B. So again we need to add it to the A. So the result will be the same, similar. So A plus 2's complement of B. So 2's complement of B, so A minus B is equal to A plus 2's complement of B, right? So here also again two conditions. So if we get carry, the result will be positive. In this case, we need to ignore the carry. So we don't need to add the carry to the LSB as we done in 1's complement. Here we need to ignore the carry, so the result will be positive. And we got the final result. If we don't get carry, means the result in 2's complement form, and also the result is negative. So the result is negative, and also the result is in 2's complement form. So we need to perform again 2's complement to get the final result. So let me give an example, then it will be clear to you. So here we need to perform 2's complement of B. So to perform 2's complement, initially we need to once perform 1's complement. So B is 0, 1, 0, 1. So 1's complement of B will be 1, 0, 1, 0. So 2's complement will be, so we need to add 1 to the LSB. So 1, 1, 0, 1. So 1, 0, double 1 is the 2's complement of B. So now we need to add A to get A minus B. So here we are adding A. So A is 1, 1, 1, 1. So 1 plus 1, 0. So 1 plus 1, 0. 0 plus 1, 1. So carry. 1 plus 1, 0. So 1 plus 1, 1, 0. 0 plus 1, 1. So we have carry. So 1010. So we get query. So the result is in positive form. So here we need to ignore the carry. So we don't need to consider the carry. So on the we got the final result as it is. So 1010 is in decimal representation 10. So the result will be plus 10. So here also we got plus 10, plus 10. So this is binary subtraction using 2's complement. So this is one case. So alternative case, we have another case also. I will give example for that case also. So let me take A as 5. 0101. B as 15, same. So 5 minus 15, the result needs to be minus 10, right? So the same procedure, no change in the procedure, whatever it might be, the number. B is 1111. So we need to perform 2's complement. To perform 2's complement, we will take initially 1's complement. 1's complement will be 0000. So 2's complement will be 1's complement plus 1. So we need to add 1 to the LSB. So the result will be 0001. So this is the 2's complement of B. So now we need to add A to the 2's complement. So A 0101. So we need to add. So 1 plus 1, 0 carry. So 0110. So no carry. So no carry means the result is in negative. No carry means the result is in negative. And also it is in 2's complement form. To get the final result, again we need to perform 2's complement on this number. So 0101. So this is the result, or we need to perform 2's complement to get the final result. So let me perform 2's complement on it. So to perform 2's complement, initially we need to take the 1's complement. So 0101, 1's complement will be 1001. So 2's complement. 1's complement plus 1. So 1 plus 1, 0, carry 1, 0, 1. So 1010, which is 10. So since we don't get any carry, so it is negative, and also we got 10 as the result. So the result will be minus 10. So we got the exact result. So this is about binary subtraction using 1's complement as well as using 2's complement. So very simple. So this is the end of today's session. So I think you got a clear idea on the binary addition as well as binary subtraction using complements. So why we are using complements means to decrease the difficulty in the binary subtraction. So in the next class we are going to see some more operations on binary numbers. So in the previous class we seen BCD, gray code, XS3. So there are different codes, right? So in the next class we are going to see additions and subtraction on those codes, means BCD addition, BCD subtraction, etc. Thank you.